Hey y'all, welcome. This is Massive Beer Reviews. My name's Matt, and gonna get down some beers. Got two beer reviews to do tonight. Two beer reviews from two relatively new breweries, for me at least. this one, Time Materials. New in a sense that they're a brewery. I've been drinking a lot of Brian's beers over the past year or two, couple of years, and he's finally made the jump from kind of homebrew, nano homebrew, to like nano brewery and selling stuff out there in the world for people to buy. He sent me four cans. I've already done two. This is the third one, and this is their New England IPA, time-honored local remedy. Yeah. This is actually a collab. Time-honored local remedy is Time Materials is a family brewing of Reading, Mass. We partner with our friends at Hopothecary Ales in North Reading to bring you this New England IPA. Built on top of a base of locally sourced malt from Stone Path Malt in Wareham, Mass, and hops from Four Star Farms in Northfield, Mass. This beer is everything you want from any IPA with a bit of local flair. So yeah, I'm kind of curious to see where this one lands. This is cans 2.8. It is 3.15. So you can see the ABV there too. It's a little bit over a month old. That shouldn't be an issue. And we'll see what's what. So, yeah. Got an unboxing to do later. You guys will see that if you watch all my stuff by the time this goes up, because those are always live. Well, not always, but 99% of the time those are live now. So yeah, label-wise, it's cool. Like I said, in the previous reviews I did from Time Materials, a departure from what their old labeling was like, but I do dig it. So yeah, hazy-wise, that looks all the part of a New England, words are hard, New England Hazy IPA. Man, my white balance is so crazy. I got my ISO now. Now my white balance is, see how dark and light it gets on certain things. I'm going to have to figure out what's going on here. It's complaining about my camera reviews, basically, at this point. I'm burping and I haven't even had a beer yet. But yeah, it's that rich orange glow. Nice, beautiful, kind of soft, creamy head. It looks all the part of what you want from a nice New England style IPA. Let's check out the nose. It smells all the parts that you want from a New England IPA. One of those drop out all bitterness, give me all that fruit juiciness. Running the gamut, you know, you're getting your citrus and getting a heaping helping of stone fruit. Dash of tropical fruit. It's more of that stone fruit kind of citrus for me, but there's definitely bits and pieces of each in there. Nice fullness to it, almost like a medley. You know, when you get the kind of like, you have orange juice, a little bit of this, and, tropical fruit, a little bit of this. It's almost like this is that mixture, that tropical orange, tropical orange juice, stone fruit mixture of equal proportions. I'm rusty, man. What can I say? It's so foreign to do beer reviews, like, every few and far between now. But it just smells like a really nice, well-done, probably not going to be all that bittering kind of New England-style IPA. I'm really surprised because it is really kind of hard to get this level of lightness and pretty softness and fruit richness from, like, New England area ingredients, like pretty much hyper local ingredients up there, so that's actually pretty impressive, at least on the nose, because it smells like something that's just like, you know, a lot of brew sugars, so you don't get a big malt base, and then there's a big fruit juiciness, so you're thinking, you know, Galaxy Cascade something, or Galaxy Citrus, something along those lines. We're just gonna dive in. Cheers. Okay, it is bitter. I like that. And you can actually do get a nice malt graininess from it. It's not malt heavy. It's not malt forward. I don't want to say that. But you do get a nice kind of malt forwardness from the beer. Not expected. But it comes off a really nice way. It doesn't come off as heavy, overly sweet. That's the important part here. It still has this kind of, not confectionery level sweetness, but this nice lightness to it. Mouth feels super soft and creamy. Definitely not going to be confused with something even close to being thin. But it is that kind of bittering that jumps out at me. It's a tiny bit West Coasty. Not, I wouldn't say it's that big, but it has that hints of those old school sea hops and a little Chinook Cascade, the Centennial kind of bite to it. I actually enjoy that on here. So you get that kind of illusion of that drop out all bitterness on the nose, on the taste. Get a juicy New England style IPA. I would probably say more now, leaning a little bit more tropical fruit, a little bit more stone fruit, and kind of moving away a little bit from the citrus from what I got on the nose. But it's honestly just really tasty stuff. Probably one of the better New England style IPAs I've had as of late in general. You know, and that's, you know, it's weird because when you have personal relationships, like I do with Brian, you know, and more than just, hey, send me some beer and I'll talk about it kind of things. You know, we chatted, we did the podcast together, all that kind of stuff. You know, you really, it's almost my inclination to be a little bit tougher. I don't know why, but a little bit tougher and not as... I shouldn't be this way, but not as just free flowing of praise and stuff like that. But I gotta say, the beers that I've had, those three that I've had from him, that he's produced now on the other side of things, being a professional brewer, are just really, really well done stuff. And they all have, well, and I think I said this a lot in the Barrel Aged Stout review. I said it in the Saison too. They all have similarities and traits with a lot of really well done versions of what they're doing, but they all taste individual in a sense too. They're not just, you know what I mean, trying to mimic somebody else's beer. They're taking the positive and good influences of each one of those particular styles and then bringing your own flair to it. I think that is very important. A lot of people just try to make facsimiles of other people's beers. It's not the case here. It's a really well done IPA. Leans heavily in New England, but you have that bittering component, which kind of centers in some old school. And a really nice, tasty collab. Like I said, I've never heard of the other brewery, never had anything from them. But just that big, juicy component with that nice kind of staunch bittering and that interplay back and forth between those two, it ends up being a really, really tasty, really well-done hazy IPA. I'd almost say it's not really even a New England IPA. It is a hazy IPA, but the bitterness here is just big enough to kind of keep it out of there. But that's just kind of nitpicking BJCP garbage stuff that I could just say it's a New England-style hazy. It's tasty. I dig it. I like the bittering. There you go. Yeah. I like to run in the game of the fruits. I like it. What can I say? Wish I had more of these. Why don't you send me a 4-pack? Send me 4 4-packs. No, I'm joking. Nah, this is something I definitely like to chug a couple of them. And that's the other part that I probably almost forgot, but I'll say it. Drinks more like a double IPA than as a single IPA. You're talking about 6.8% of a drink. This blend, I think it would lean a little bit. Nah, maybe mid-7s, pushing towards 8. It lacks that big sweetness to really get it to double IPA territory. But definitely, there's a lot of beers that are 6.8 that drink like 5. This is 6.8 drinking bigger than itself, and that's definitely where I like my beers to sit. So, is it one of the better ones I've had as late? Yes. Rush War status? I mean, it's up there, but I mean, I think there's ones that have done me better. But, you know, you give this to me at a decent price point off a shelf, I'd see myself picking this up on a reg. And, let me know. Y'all? Mass heads. Massholes? Mass heads? Some of you peoples out there who've had Time Materials, let me know what you've had from them. Let me know what you think. If you're looking to try it, I'm assuming it's Mass only, but I'm sure if you go to the Time Materials website, and I'll tell you where that you can find their beer. That's all I got, man. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this review. Go check him out. Go check them out. We'll see you next time. Cheers.